This video is an introduction to the course Microbial Community Analysis with Chipster, and it's an introduction to microbial community analysis in general. So during this course, you will learn about microbial community analysis of amplicon sequencing data, the central concepts, analysis steps, and file formats. In the exercises, we use 16S ribosomal RNA data from the MySeq platform. But during the course, we also discuss how to analyze data from the Ion Torrent platform and how to analyze the fungal IDS data. During the course, in the exercises, you will also learn how to operate the Chipster software, which is very easy. So before we start, I just want to remind you why it's useful to understand data analysis. Bioinformaticians are not always available when you need them. On the other hand, as a biologist, you know your own experiments best, so you know what happened in the lab. For example, you know if there are potential batch effects in the data, and so forth. Understanding data analysis also allows you to design experiments better, so you can save money. And it enables you to discuss more easily with bioinformaticians. But let's move on now to the actual microbial community analysis. So in this section, you will learn what kind of questions microbial community analysis can answer, how it's done, and what are the main steps. So, microbial community analysis answers the questions who are there and in what proportions if compared to your other samples. So, it's important that the comparison is between samples that have been treated the same way. It's also important to realize that you cannot directly compare the numbers between the different bacteria, for example, because the gene copy numbers for this kind of marker genes we use here vary a lot. So obviously, if one bacteria has, say, the 16S gene in one copy and the other one has 15 copies, then that would reflect in the counts we get. It's also important to realize that this kind of data will not confirm that someone isn't there. So this can depend on sampling depth, but even however much you sequence, there can be a bias for primers or sequencing. So the way how this is usually done is we have specific primers that are used to amplify a region of one gene. There can be different types of genes here depending on what you are studying. The very common one is the 16S ribosomal RNA gene. For fungal analysis, you would use the IDS or internal transcribed spacer between these genes. Typically, the sequencing is done using Illumina MySeq platform or Ion Torrent. And nowadays, it's also possible to use the PacBio in order to obtain full-length sequences rather than just pieces of the gene, and in this way you could get better resolution. Now finally, let's make a difference between microbial community analysis and metagenomics. So in metagenomics, the aim is to sequence all the genes, and it answers the questions who are there and what they are capable of doing. So in this slide here, it's borrowed from Dr. Anu Mikkonen from University of Jyväskylä. So here we have the structure of the 16S ribosomal RNA gene. And down here in this graph, we show how conserved the different regions are. So on the x-axis, we have the base position in the 16S gene, and on the y-axis, we have the level of conservation, essentially. So you can see that there are areas which are very well conserved, and these are the areas where we design the primers for. And then we amplify the regions in between. So these are the variable regions, what we usually call V1, V3, V4, and so forth. The analysis, the bioinformatics of microbial community analysis consists of essentially three major parts. So there is a lot of pre-processing, then the classification, and then finally we get to the actual community analysis and visualization. So in this course, we will cover all these steps in detail. So to start with, we will talk about quality control and how to remove primers and adapters and bad quality read ends if they exist. Then in the case of MySeq data, which is paired end, we need to combine the paired end reads to contigs. In the case of ion torrent data, at this point, we just combine all the FASTQ files into one big FASTA file. Then we filter out bad quality sequences, remove identical sequences, so we extract the unique ones, because there is no point doing, for example, alignment for identical sequences. We can just align one and then project the results to the others. So we align the sequences to a reference database, such as Silva for the 16S data or Unite for the RDS data. After that, we need to still filter the aligned sequences based on alignment position, and we also remove empty columns, so the gap columns and overhangs. After that, we remove sequencing errors, so we pre-cluster very similar sequences, and we remove chimeras, and then we are ready for classification. When we classify, we essentially assign the sequences to taxonomies. And once that is done, then we are ready for the community analysis and visualization. Jesse will talk about that. And also here, this will involve a lot of data tidying, transformations, etc. But finally, we can answer questions like, does the community structure differ between sample groups, which groups are different, which taxa are differentially abundant between sample groups.